cross him. The left goes to the right goes to the left. This guy crosses here, he crosses here. They have no idea where we are, who we are, where we're coming from, or who we're throwing to.
Very interesting.
This is the Texas Gunslinger's new team logo and promotional ad for the World Wide Web Football League. That's the fun part, the make-believe part of this story. I had this made at one of those car wrap places. This will be put on the back window of my SUV Monday morning. It is one of those things where they cannot see in, but you can see out. They would not let me use something copyrighted, so I used my World Wide Web Football League team and added the Spartans just for fun.
Dalvin Cooks.
How about them running backs all getting paid?
Alvin Kamara got paid as well. This guy's been paid. Russell Wilson. He surpasses 4,000 rushing yards
during their video conferencing meetings.
This is the last Week 4 game in the WWWFL. The Sacramento Gunslingers defeated the CV Badgers by a score of 33-7. Randy Leeper is the head coach of the Sacramento Gunslingers, and Larry Zorn is the head coach of the CV Badgers. The Gunslingers quarterback Russell Wilson broke out of a slump to become the player of the game and the player of the week. Wilson was unstoppable, completing 91% of his passes for 296 yards and 3 TDs. Halfback Austin Eckler saw his first action of the season, rushing 10 times for 59 yards and 1 TD. Eckler also had 10 receptions for 63 yards. The Badgers' terrific Tom Brady would not call the halfback's number. Brady dropped back and threw the ball 48 times, completing 56% of his passes for 223 yards, 1 TD, and 3 interceptions. The one-dimensional offense made it easier for the Gunslingers' defense, but with Russell Wilson on fire, what else could the Badgers do? The Sacramento Gunslingers are now 2-2, and the CV Badgers are also 2-2.
Clearly the strength of that defense. Wilson's going to step up, fakes a throw, off he goes, and Russell to the races to the 16-yard line.
Back to
hasn't been overall all that good tonight either.
So second down now. Burrow throws on a run. Wow.
The Florence Freedom defeat the Pembroke Pine Eagles by a score of 35-13. Brandon Wright is the head coach of the Florence Freedom, and John Wright is the head coach of the Pembroke Pine Eagles, the Wright brothers. The Freedom's quarterback Joe Burrow had another nice game. In fact, he was the player of the game, completing 78% of his passes for 307 yards, 2 TDs, and 1 interception. The Freedom's run game helped run out the clock, rushing 35 times for 137 yards. Burrow's favorite target was tight end George Kittle. He had 9 receptions for 129 yards. The Eagles quarterback Lamar Jackson's luck ran out this week. Jackson completed 38% of his passes for 115 yards, 2 TDs, and 2 interceptions. Halfback Jonathan Taylor is making a case for an increased workload. Taylor had only 14 rushing attempts but got 122 yards. Nice work. The Florence Freedom is now 3-2, and the Pembroke Pine Eagles are now 2-3.
Burrow slinging it again, this time near side of the field.
And Philadelphia had problems with stacks and tight ends last week against the Rams.
Where does Burrow go here? From the gun, he fakes, throwing to the end zone, wide open.
Bills gave up 14 sacks the first 3 weeks, tied for the most in the NFL, and down goes Allen. He hesitated.
The Portland Storm defeated the Greenwich Spartans by a score of 23-6. Windsor Cooper is the head coach of the Portland Storm, and Scott Smith, founder of our league, is the head coach of the Greenwich Spartans. The Storm's defense rained all over the Spartans, starting with forcing a fumble on the opening kickoff. Later, outside linebacker Bradley Chubb forced tight end Travis Kelce to fumble in the first quarter. Adrian Phillips and Xavier Rhodes both picked off Bridgewater in the second. Jabril Peppers fumbles a punt return in the fourth, and backup quarterback Mason Rudolph throws a pick in the fourth as the cherry on top of this defensive game. The defense is the player of the game. The Spartans never had a chance. Quarterback Bridgewater had his worst game of the season. His two picks in this game were his first all year. But the Spartans run a ball control offense. They are not built to come from behind, as three fumbles and three interceptions will tend to do to a team. The Portland Storm is now 3-2, and the Greenwich Spartans are also 3-2.
Play. Kenny Clark came away with it, and the officials are yet to signal. Now they do. Packers football. Buffalo now in green.
Robinson up the middle. He's got the first down and more. There he goes again. Robinson off to the races, and they catch him at the 20.
The Lakeland Lizards defeated the Atlanta Bluet by a score of 34-10. Kurt Retzlaff is the head coach of the Lakeland Lizards, and Chris Chambers is the head coach of the Atlanta Bluet. The Lizards quarterback Matthew Stafford had struggled all season. Today was no different. Stafford completed 63% of his passes for 204 yards, 2 TDs, and 2 interceptions. The player of the game is James Robinson, who has been consistent all season long. Today he exploded for 126 yards on 17 rushing attempts and got 1 TD. Wide receiver Cooper Culp also had a nice day, 9 receptions for 108 yards and 1 TD. The Bluet this game looked a lot like the Week 4 game. Quarterback Aaron Rodgers had a very average day. You might say below average for Mr. Rodgers. The run game was no help. Todd Gurley had only 14 rushing attempts for 72 yards and 1 TD. True, that's a 5.1 yards per carry average, but not enough attempts to make the difference. The Lakeland Lizards are now 3-2, and the Atlanta Blue is now 2-3.
And Robinson's up to the 42-yard line.
This is what this offense wants to do. Little zone read. Gardner Minshew's reading the defensive end there, handing it off to Robinson.
Redskins defensive coordinator, 4 years, same position with the Colts. Look, end zone. It is caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Back shoulder to Eric Ebron. He's covering him.
The Sacramento Gunslingers defeated the Eau Claire Rockers by a score of 17-13. Randy Leeper is the head coach of the Sacramento Gunslingers, and Steve Branvold is the head coach of the Eau Claire Rockers. The Gunslingers' run game did their job, rushing 27 times for 133 yards. Quarterback Russell Wilson was back to being just above average in Week 5. The Gunslingers trailed the entire game. The Rockers, up 13-10 over the Gunslingers, had the ball with 5:42 left in the fourth. When halfback Chris Carson fumbled the ball, the Gunslingers took over around midfield and went 3-and-out, punting it back to the Rockers with 3:12 left on the clock. The Rockers also went 3-and-out, looking to punt with 1:18 left. Punter Sam Kosh shanked it for a whopping 14 yards. The Gunslingers use their timeouts and score with no time left on the clock to win 17-13. The player of the game is Eric Ebron, 5 receptions for 31 yards. Not impressive, but he did have the 2 TDs in the fourth quarter. The Rockers' defense played well, as did the offense, but the offense could not find the end zone. Too many field goals. The Sacramento Gunslingers are now 3-2, and the Eau Claire Rockers are now 2-3.
Good for the goose, good for the gander, Trent. They did the same play. They faked a screen out wide, and Andrew hits Eric Ebron.
No catches today for T.Y. Hilton on 3rd and 4. Luck looking deep for the end zone. Ebron down there, goes up, and he's got it! Touchdown! What a throw and catch! The 7th touchdown of the...
There are 2 Week 5 games that still need to be played. The Jersey Jedis versus the Washington Deadskins, and the CV Badgers versus the Sheboygan Mashers. I'll get to those games as soon as they're played. Thank you.